Good morning, everyone. Welcome all of you to the worship service of Belfast United Methodist Church. How are you? I hope you are all well this morning. Today, I have a few announcements to share with you. The first one, we had Christmas fair yesterday. I just want to say thank you to those who worked really hard. Pat and her friend Juanita, and then it is June, and then Susan and Victor. I can name them all. I cannot remember everyone, but you know who worked, right? And also, God knows. So thank you everyone for working really hard. It was a great turnout, and then thanks to your support, the church can sustain its ministry. So thank you very much. The second announcement, today, finally, we reopen our church for in-person worship service. So we continue virtual worship service and drive-in worship service at 9:30, and we do this in-person worship service at 11 o'clock. So you can choose one of these. And Bible study, this Friday, we start our online Bible study. We are going to read Ephesians. As we read together, we reflect on the message, the meaning of it, and also pray together. So I pray as we have this time together, God strengthen our faith, also helps us grow in love of God. And the last announcement, next Sunday at 7 o'clock, we are going to have church conference, annual church conference. So during this week, you will receive your booklet, the booklet for church conference through email. So please participate in this annual church conference. You can just stay home and then just turn to your computer and then you can participate in it, okay? And then if you don't have email address, please call the church office and then you can come and pick up the booklet for church conference. All right, then I think I forgot to tell you the Bible study time. So this Thursday, 6:30, so we are going to have 4 weeks Bible study, Thursday, 6:30, okay? All right, then, now I invite you to center yourselves for this moment and then feel the presence of the Holy Spirit in your place as we sing together, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. So now let us together sing. Things that are pure and pleasing. Things that are excellent and worthy of praise. Come, Holy Spirit, and incline our heart toward you. And now please join me in the opening prayer. Almighty God, we come before you this morning with thankful heart for the many blessings you have given us. May we be ever mindful of your loving presence today and every day as we seek to do your will. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning. The scripture reading today is from Philippians 4, verses 1 through 9. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord in this way, my beloved. I urge Euodia and I urge Syntyche to be of the same mind in the Lord. Yes, and I also ask you also, my loyal companion, help these women, for they have struggled beside me in the work of the gospel, together with Clement and the rest of my co-workers, whose names are in the book of life. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. Let your gentleness be known to everyone. The Lord is near. Do not worry about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, beloved, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing the things that you have learned and received and heard and seen in me, and the God of peace will be with you. May the Lord bless the reading of this scripture.
Good morning again. let me share with you a funny story with hymn titles. This is for those who speed on the highway, for those who drive 45 miles per hour. God will take care of you, the hymn title, right? 65 miles per hour, nearer my God to thee. 85 miles per hour, this world is not my home. 95 miles per hour, Lord, I am coming home. 100 miles per hour, precious memories. I hope you enjoyed it. This morning, we read Philippians. Paul was in prison, and he had a choice to make. Reasonably, he could have chosen to be bitter, focusing on the negative, all that was wrong with his life, all he had lost. But instead, he chose to focus on the positive, on all that was right, and all that he still had. Being in prison, he had every reason to be depressed. But instead, he wrote this way, Rejoice in the Lord always. He had every reason to complain about his dire circumstances, right? But instead, he wrote, "With thanksgiving, let your request be known to God." He had every reason to look on the dark side of his circumstance, but he wrote this way, "Whatever is pleasing, whatever is commendable, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about those things." He had every reason to give up, but instead, he said this, "I press on, and I can do all things through him, Jesus Christ, who strengthens me." This verse comes later, after the scriptures we read this morning. But I really want to share with this verse with you. If you come to my office, you will see a wall frame with this verse, "I can do all things through him who strengthens me." This is one of my favorite Bible verses, which has inspired not only me, but also many people in the church history. He said that in prison. We now see Paul as an optimist. I don't know if you know about this, we Methodists are also optimists. We believe God's love and grace are upon every single person. And we believe that the world will finally be reconciled to God through Jesus Christ, our Lord. We always focus on God's grace in our lives, the true source, bringing joy and thanksgiving into our lives. We are truly radical optimists. So as we gather together, I would like to remind you of the truth that you chose to live as optimists in Christ. I also would like to encourage you to be joyful and thankful in your lives. That is exactly what Paul did in prison. That is exactly what God wants us to live. You see, in the different situations in life, we all have the choice of what we will maximize and what we will minimize. And the person who has learned to choose gratitude for the positive in the midst of the negative is far better equipped to cope with whatever comes and to make the best of things in the worst of times. I'm sure you know about that. When Paul wrote to the Philippians, he knew that his friend in Philippi would soon face, and even then were facing, persecutions and rejection because of their faith in Christ. Paul wrote this letter to them while he was confined to a Roman prison cell under the sentence of death because of his faith in Christ. He knew about the result of their choice, but in his dire situation, he said this, "The peace of God, which passes all understanding, will guard your heart and mind in Christ Jesus." He was not writing about a sense of peace that denies the painful realities of life, but instead a peace that existed in the midst of them, the painful realities. It was a sense of peace that was not based on logic, but rather on relationship. Not based on the environment around you, but rather on the friend beside you, who is Jesus Christ our Lord, who has been born to us, for us, and to be with us in our times of need. Some choices significantly affect our lives. A choice made by Adam changed the world, the whole world. His choice brought sin and death into our lives, and we call that original sin. Because of the fall of Adam, we lost the intimacy in relationship with God. We lost our goodness in us, and since then, we have inclined to choose something wrong, something against God's will. That is the nature of human beings according to the Bible. Now, I got to say this. Please don't think that I'm not an optimist. I'm now presenting the biblical understanding of the nature of human beings. And actually, this is not the story, not the end of the story in the Bible. We lost our intimacy with God. However, we have this faith. God is still with us. And God's grace is available to everyone. So this is why I am also an optimist. Even though we have this simple nature, we can be good before God, thanks to God's grace. God is with us, and with God's grace, we are no longer bound to sin and death. We are free, thanks to the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. As Adam had free will to choose, we also have free will to choose whatever it is. You can choose doing this or not doing this or that. It is our choice. What I really appreciate and am glad is that you choose to respond to God's grace as you join in our worship service today. You choose to have faith in God. You choose to live as God's people in your lives. Your choice changed your lives. And I believe that also changing the world. As we serve our God and our neighbors, as we pray for peace and justice in the world, we are choosing. I believe that the world is changing little bit day by day. I believe that we are participating in God's divine plan to build the kingdom of God as we continue choosing the will of God in the course of our faith journey. So this morning, I pray that the Holy Spirit strengthens us and fills us wisdom as we choose God's will in the course of our faith journey. Amen. And now let us together have a moment to pray for those in need, to pray for our church and also our neighbors. I am pretty sure that you have your prayer request, so please lift up your prayer request to our God as you have this moment of silent prayer and pastoral prayer. So now I would like to invite you into the moment of silent prayer. O Holy God, we come before you in prayer, lifting to you the joys and concerns, the hopes and dreams of our lives. May we also be open to your voice in our lives, that we may see with new eyes and hear with new ears the direction you will have us to go. This morning we give thanks to you for what you have done for us. Bless, as we pray, your people, that we may grow and flourish in your love and grace for the purpose to which you have called us. And Lord, guide us and bless us, uplift us and hold us, for we are your children, called to your purpose in your world. Merciful God, hear our prayers for those whose lives have touched us, those who are in pain, those who are ill, those who grieve. May we touch their lives not only through our prayers, Lord, but through our lives and actions as well. Lord, have mercy on us and guide us and lead us so that your beloved children who are in need of your healing presence feel your grace and love. Almighty God, in this time of great stress and threats of health and safety of many, we lift to you the world, our country, and also the world. Lord, have mercy on us and lead us into the path you want us to go. We pray for those whose lives are heavily affected by the COVID-19. We pray for the doctors, nurses, and caretakers who take care of the people who are in need. Lord, be with them and strengthen them with your Spirit. We pray for your church, Lord, both here in this faith community and around the world, that this time of challenge might be a time of renewal in faith and mission on your behalf, and that together we may learn the path of servanthood toward all humanity. Loving God, we give thanks to you for listening to our prayer and pray. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespassers against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now, out of gratitude for the love of God, we offer our thanksgiving offering and tithes to our God. Let us together say the prayer of dedication. By the goodness of God, we are called into the family of the church. By God's grace, we rejoice to share in the church's life of mission and ministry. Bless our offerings and use them for your divine plan for the world. Amen. Christ our Lord invites to his table all who love him, who honestly repent of their sin, and seek to live in peace with one another. Lift up your heart and give thanks to God. Blessed are you, O God, who with your word and Holy Spirit created all things and called them good. In Jesus Christ, your word became flesh and dwelt among us. Through Jesus' suffering and death, you took upon yourself our sin and death and destroyed their power forever. You raised from the dead the same Jesus who now reigns with you in glory, and poured upon us your Holy Spirit, making us the people of your new covenant. On the night Before meeting with death, Jesus took bread. Gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, Take it, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When the supper was over, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to his disciples and said, Drink from this all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. Poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. And so, in remembrance of this, your mighty action, Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice, in union with Christ's offering for us. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and on this gift, that in the breaking of this bread and the drinking of this wine, we may know the presence of the living Christ and be renewed as the body of Christ for the world, redeemed by His Christ's blood, until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at your table forever. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. The body of Christ broken for us, the blood of Christ shed for us for our salvation. Let us together take it. Let us pray. Eternal God, we give thanks for this holy mystery in which you have given yourself to us. Grant that we may go into the world in the strength of your Spirit to give ourselves for others. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our closing hymn for our worship service today is How Great Thou Art. Let us together sing. God is with you now and forever. Amen.